So here, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, being in this particular badia with these children as he grew up, something happened. What happened? They used to play outside with the boys. They used to play with what? With the sheep and goats and so on. You know, little children in a little village out there, and they used to play. And one day, his friend, the one who was also his brother, his foster brother, the one who was being breastfed by the same Halimatu Sa'diyah, they were playing together, and two angels came down. And the angels came down in white clothing. This young boy, the both of them saw the angels, and the angels put Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam down on his back, slit open his chest, took out his heart, and this young boy began to run. Run where? He ran straight to Halimatu Sa'diyah, and he began to tell them what's going on. In the meantime, the angels had taken out this heart. They had brought a bowl, a golden bowl made of gold with zamzam in it. For your information, the zamzam had started gushing just before that, because it was there from the time of Ismail alayhi salam, but it was clogged and it was re-dug by Abdul Muttalib, as we learned yesterday. And now the same water was being used to purify the heart from what? Jealousy, hatred, deception, pride, and all these bad qualities, the quality of anger for the wrong reasons. Remember, when we become upset, we can become upset for the sake of Allah. But a lot of the times it's just for our own selves. Whereas Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, it is reported by Aisha radiallahu anha, she says, "Man taqama li nafsihi qattu." He never ever sought revenge for himself. He didn't get angry because someone wronged him, but he always did so when someone obviously went against the law and command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It would make him upset. And whenever he sought revenge and retaliation, it was solely for the sake of Allah, not never for himself. With us, sake of Allah, we can leave it to go by. But for ourselves, we won't let it go by. I'm going to fix him, whether now or tomorrow. But you're going to see what I'm going to do to him. Allah protect us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soften our hearts. Remember, it's shaitan who wants you to continue the circle. You do, he does. He does back, you do again, and so on. And it carries on and on for years on end, just like the jahiliyyah. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was purified. The heart was replaced. A little vein was taken from the back, just from the left side and the back, and it was removed. And this was, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains in one narration, he says, you see, shaitan is like a little frog here on your left side. Whenever you are engaged in the remembrance of Allah, shaitan is silent. And the minute you are oblivious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he begins to whisper in your ear. Starts whispering what? Anything and everything. To start doing wrong and, you know, divulge you. Like people read salah. And you know, a man reading salah one day, he says, 250. What do you mean 250? 200, oh, okay, I mean salah, sorry. He was busy calculating what people owed him. Allahu Akbar. Because why? In salah, we're busy thinking of everything else. What am I going to do after salah? People are saying, there's a braai on tonight. This sheikh is taking too long. Come on. Taraweeh is finishing 9 o'clock. Imagine. And another 7 minutes for witr. What's going on here, man? Subhanallah. That goes through our minds because we are oblivious of Allah. You take out that shaitan, a little frog from there, throw him out. Allahu Akbar. How do you throw him out? By continuing to remember Allah. Thank Allah. He is giving you an opportunity that you may never ever get again. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all and grant us goodness. So when that vein was taken, and it is reported that there was now a seal of prophethood there. What was it? It was a mark here, a little like a pea, the size of a small pea here on his back. And it had a few hairs, like a mole we would say today. It had a little bit of like a mark, and it had a few hairs that grew out of it. Subhanallah. And this was in a specific place on his back. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Halimatu Sa'diyah and them rushed out to see what was going on, he was sitting there pale. Everything was over, obviously. And they asked him what happened, and he narrated the story. Now they got worried. They were worried for his life. Because you see, even prior to this, the grandfather was told so much. The mother had a few signs here and there. Not a direct piece of information. Some people say the angel Jibreel came to the mother. No, that's wrong. The angel Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam did not come to the mother of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. But there were other signs which were lesser signs to prove that this man is going to be someone important. You know, like nowadays we see a youngster, very, very intelligent. We say, watch this page. Watch this space. That's what some people say. Look at this young boy. He's going to be very important, inshallah. He's going to be a big man, inshallah. He's going to come and something, inshallah, big will happen. We're just guessing. But in that case, no guessing. It was something that was coming. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they took him, and what did they do? They returned him. They went back to Makkah, and they saw the mother, and they saw the grandfather, and they said, "We are returning this young boy." But why? "No, we are busy. We have this." "No, no, no. Tell us the reason." "No, we have this excuse." "No, no, no. Tell us, why is it that you are bringing this child back?" And then she says, "Well, this is what happened. There was the angels, or someone came down. They slit the chest, and there was a mark that was left on the chest, subhanallah, which remained up to the end. And Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu says, I used to see the mark left by that cutting of the chest from the angels, subhanallah. Later on, even in the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, a little mark. Sometimes we have operations, and then you have the visible mark for a long, long time. This only Allah knows exactly how it was, but there was a mark. Subhanallah. So what could Amina do? Binti Wahab, she accepted her child back, looked after the child with the assistance of whom? With the assistance of Ummu Ayman, who was her slave.